We're at the Belfry today, where we've spent the last 4 months testing more than 160 2018 golf clubs for Top Gear, TG's annual mega equipment test. We've got Ben Frost, senior instructor here at the PGA National Academy, Simon Daddo, TG's gear editor, and today we're talking about fairway woods. We've picked our top 10 2018 woods, and here they are. Simon, of all the balls we've hit, of all the numbers we've got from our GC Quad launch monitor, one model in particular stood out over Head and Shoulders this year.
That has to be the M4. It doesn't happen that often at all, but for us, for all three testers, the M4 was 9 yards longer for Ben, 5 yards longer for me, 5 yards longer for you, mm-hmm. than any other club that we tested. That really doesn't happen very often.
Yeah. Ben, I mean, obviously TaylorMade have got two fairways in our top 10. They've got the M3 and the M4, very different. I mean, they look similar, but in terms of adjustability, M4's not got any, M3's got loads. How do you choose between them?
Well, there is a price difference, of course. If you're going to find the adjustability useful, if you want to really dial in specific numbers on your fairway woods, whether it's spin rates or heights, launch angles, that sort of thing, then yeah, you might want to go for the more expensive, the more adjustable one. Mm-hmm. If you don't see the benefit, then why bother?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you really have to see that extra benefit from using that weight. You know, there's no point at all in paying extra to buy the M3 but not using that weight and that adjustability.
Mm-hmm. Considering how well the M4 performs anyway, from our numbers.
Yeah.
And just looking at the tour players as well, pretty much all of them use the M3, apart from John Rahm, just because they want to dial in that very specific shot shape. So yes, it's expensive, but you need to make sure that you're really seeing the benefits of that extra adjustability to warrant the cost.
But here at the Belfry, you're seeing out of every 10 fairway woods you're selling, you're seeing one M3 and nine M4s going out the door. So for amateur golfers, for club golfers like us two, there's a lot of technology in that head to help you hit it further and straighter.
Yeah, it's not only in the head either. You know, the Atmos shaft that we didn't think was great in the driver, actually in the fairway, in the hybrid, really performed extremely well for all three of us, mm-hmm. which is unheard of as well. Mm-hmm. You know, that really does help you to launch shots off the turf and just keep them in the air, you know, a fraction longer as well. You know, it really did perform extremely well for us.
Mm. And the other big innovation story in fairways this year is Callaway's jailbreak tech in the Rogue fairway woods. So last year's Epic driver had jailbreak, but the fairways didn't. This year, the fairways do have jailbreak technology, and it's made a difference. I mean, it was your second longest.
It was my fairway. Second longest. So I'm assuming that the jailbreak is making a difference there. It's given us some higher ball speeds. From an impressive point, though, I had Mizuno was my second longest as well. So there was a bit of competitiveness there on the distance.
Mm. Yeah, jailbreak's good and absolutely fantastic in the driver. For me, on a personal level, I would say it's slightly harder to make a steelhead, you know, fairway or hybrids perform in the same way as a driver. Mm. But obviously, you want advantages stacked in your favour, and I would say that jailbreak is an advantage over lots of the competition.
One thing that Callaway does really well, and TaylorMade to be fair, is that they offer both fairways in lots of different lofts. Mm-hmm. You know, the Callaway is available as a 25 degree 11 wood, and the TaylorMade comes in at 24 degrees, it's a 7 wood. That's got to be a good thing for club golfers, and you were saying that, you know, a lot of club golfers should be looking at fairways and hybrids for anything upwards of a 6-iron.
Absolutely. I see a lot of golfers who don't get the height on their irons. So they're not stopping the ball on the greens, they're not getting the carry distance that they really want, so their long irons start to bunch up and they start to get a little bit close. So you need loft, simple answer. If you're not taking divots with your irons, you're hitting quite level, you might be thinning your irons a little bit, so catching it low on the face. A lofted wood is going to get the ball higher, it's going to carry it further. So yeah, you're going to bridge the gap between your irons and your driver.
Yeah, it really is the point now to admit I can't hit a 5-iron, you know, because there are some great options out there, especially in fairway woods, high lofted fairway woods, to be able to replace them.
Mm. As far as the other clubs go in our top 10, I mean, there's some fantastic standout performances from the Ping, the G400, which we love.
Yeah, it is the Audi of fairway woods. Really strong, really solid, loads and loads of different options as well. For me personally, I think the SFT, which means that the head has got a bit more draw bias, is really good for the average club player. It will help you stay away from the right-hand side of the golf course. They're a little bit lighter, a little bit easier to launch off the turf. Great option.
Really good. And talking about launching it off the turf, both Cobra's King F8 and King F8 Plus, the slightly smaller tour versions, both made our top 10. And they've got these baffler rails on the sole, which is designed to help you cut through the grass more easily.
Anything that helps you rifle a fairway wood or a hybrid through the rough is a benefit, in my opinion. We don't normally recommend small-headed drivers, fairways, hybrids to anybody, but for me, the F8 Plus as a 4 or a 5 wood would make an absolutely fantastic choice. It's a really small head, really great at being able to rifle shots out of poor lies, possibly out of a bunker as well, a fairway bunker. Really, really nice little option.
All the help we can get with shots out of rough, anything that's making it a little bit easier is going to be worthwhile.
So I think I know the answer to this, but if you had to choose one of our top 10 to put in your bag for this year, which would it be?
Really simple, M4.
Yeah, has to be the same. No question at all.
Same here.